Hello and welcome to another class of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, I will be talking about the various events available within Scriptcase, and I will also be showing you how to use them. Events are an important part of Scriptcase applications, where you can add your own custom code according to the business rules of the project which you are working on. Each works differently and can have different triggers as well as requirements. Within Scriptcase, you can access events within the left menu. There, you will see a long list of available events depending on the type of application which you are viewing. Some applications have less events available. Within the form application, there are many more, as you can see here. Here I have onApplicationinit. This executes only once. Is used for initiate values that will be used for other events. So here, for instance, I could include an ID from the previous application, which I want to use in this one. onNavigate. This is triggered when you navigate through pages of the form. So if I have multiple form entries, for instance, when I navigate from one entry to another, it will trigger this specific event. onScriptinit executes after onApplicationinit. It is also the first event to be triggered after a page refresh. It is executed, however, before the application runs the main database SQL request. Then we have onLoadRecord and onLoad. The onLoad event is triggered after the script init and is responsible to load the fields of the application. For example, from this specific event, you can manipulate the field values using the braces notation. For instance, I can specify my field and then indicate a value. For the onLoad record event, it is similar to the onLoad event. But the difference is that the onLoad is only available for a single record form, and the onLoad record is available for forms that display multiple lines at the same time, such as the editable grids and the multiple records form types. The onLoad record works as a loop where it will execute for each available record. Let's see an example. I will initiate a variable on the onApplicationInit event, which I will then increment in the event onLoadRecord, and we will also print the variable within the discontinued field, which is here, and we should then be able to see that within the form. So I give the global variable 0, and here now within the discontinued field, we previously had each of these as 0, and now each field is incremented by 1. And if I also then navigate from record to record, you will see that each record is continuously updated. The onRefresh event happens whenever an event is forced. So whenever the application is forced to refresh. So let's do that. I'll add here an echo to the onRefresh event saying that onRefresh was activated. And now here within one of the select fields, I can select the option to reload the form when the value has changed. And now if I run my application again, and we will now be able to check that here, running the form. And now when I change the supplier ID, the form refreshes and I have my echo displayed at the top here. The next event is the onValidate. The onValidate events are different from all other events as they have a direct relationship with the insert, update and delete events. The onValidate event works as a decision-making tree where the onValidate would be the root to make a process fail. We need to use a Scriptcase macro called scErrorMessage. So the next event would then be the onValidateFailure. Else the process goes to the onValidateSuccess. And then we need to decide if it is an update, insert, or delete event. So before I continue, let's briefly check out this validation process. Within this image, we start with the onValidate event. And everything depends on if an error message was received or not. If not, then depending on the event type, i.e. if insert, update or delete, the next event is triggered, then being either on before or on after insert, update or delete. With this process flow, you can see where to apply which event. Now before I finish up, let's take a closer look at the code editor. Within the code editor, which is available in many of the Scriptcase applications. So this code editor features a theme selection. Here at the top, we can select from one of the themes available, which you like most. For instance, I like the blackboard theme, so I have that selected. And there is also a full screen or browser window option. For instance, I have here full screen and also full screen again. We can change the view of the code editor. I can also use Ctrl plus F to quick access that and search through the code within the code editor. Press Ctrl plus F and I receive a search. There is also here a replace feature, or alternatively we can use Ctrl plus Shift plus F. So I do that, Ctrl plus Shift plus F, to activate the search and replace. And then we can enter what we want to replace within the code editor, and it will replace the text within the main view. The F3 key to view the next search result, while Shift plus F will do the opposite. If you select a line or more, you can use the tab key. For instance, now if I come here where I have some data, if I select a line and then the tab key, it will indent the code to the right, and shift plus tab will go the opposite direction. You can also select more than one line by just holding the control key and selecting the lines with your mouse. And then to deselect, just hit the escape key. And last but not least, you have Ctrl plus Shift plus L to auto-indent selected code. Within the events, if, for example, if I close the PHP tag here within the editor, I do that again. Okay, so I'm going to close the PHP editor, and if I now, for instance, type the form tag, and then press the tab key on my keyboard, Scriptcase will automatically create the HTML form tag. And then if I type select and press tab, I create a select tag. You can see more detailed information about each available emmet shortcut in our documentation. Press F1 to quickly open it and go to Getting to Know Scriptcase. Here, select Read Manual, and then select Getting to Know Scriptcase, which is here on the left menu. And there we also then have the emmet hotkeys. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.